Welcome back again to another one of my painting sessions. This is going to be a yellow themed painting. It's a bit rare to find, but I'm going to try it. This is my fifth try at doing a yellow themed painting, so I do understand why it's a bit difficult, but I have a new style, I guess, design for it, that I think it's going to suit it well. And it's what this is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have that big can that you see in the middle is going to be the centerpiece. And then the two off to the sides will be connected by, I'm going to make it look like a small little galaxy, just rays of light, if you will. It's going up like a V, and then it will also come down like an X. Okay? What I could also do is make it like a Y. I go up there, and then I come down. I might choose the Y because I plan to do arching mountains as opposed to normal straight ridged mountains. These mountains will curve up around the main planet, almost like a cradle. So that's what I plan on doing, and I think it might do well because of that. And around that planet, around the mountains, I'm going to do like a small lake, and it's gonna have, of course, the yellows in it, but it's gonna be mainly like black and white. That's what I'm gonna do, mainly like black and white, because if I add another color, it will demean the yellow, as yellow is more soft. If I add any sort of other colors like blue, it will just draw your attention to it. So black and white is just the best choice overall. And without further ado, I'll shut up and get to painting.
Get that lid. Sorry about that. That should be all right.
It won't be perfectly symmetrical, but that's fine. I don't really care about symmetry all that much. Nature isn't that symmetrical by nature anyway. It's pretty, but not realistic, I guess. So now I'm gonna get to the background. black seemed to seep through to the white because the yellow was too wet. So that's an issue. So it looks a bit wonky. I don't really have a remedy for it. So that's unfortunate that it doesn't have any shade. And this has alright shading, but if I mean y'all could probably see when I was trying to make the lines, this lid moved, and so it created a rim. It's not really optimal, so I mean, but it's much better looking than my others. That's a big upgrade, because my others were complete failures, the other four. Okay. Now I'm going to do some misting. Should we put my gas mask on? Okay, I think that looks pretty all right. Okay, now I'm just going to set up the mountains, or the spires, right? That color isn't really working. Try to have like a dark golden, but it was too heavy. Way too heavy. So just gonna have to put this to the side really. Or I'm just gonna scrap it. It's too contaminated.
Ow, it is a very bad color.
Can I take this now? It's more black. Okay. Actually, I'm going to do the lake first. Trying to get some of the texture of the mountains in there and make it right here. Okay, and put this, and I'm just gonna take a scrap one over here. There we go. All right. just gonna add a trail of white. Some more glass. Very lightly grazing on top of the wet paint. Don't want to have too much of an impression. And go back the opposite direction that I just went through. There we go. Yeah, that's a bit too much white, but yeah, it's fine. This as cleanly as we can. There we go. Yeah, seems pretty alright. Okay, now get to those mountains. Actually, I'm gonna wait a little bit to let this dry. This it might take a bit. I don't think I'm going to add, I mean, I might add a little bit of foliage on these corners, but I don't really think I should. I think it should be fine for now, without like any interference. Okay, let's see about now. Should be fine enough. Be a bit misshapen, but that's fine. the biggest one. I'll make a smaller one over here to the side. Go. These in. And I will admit, it will be a bit difficult to get the left mountains shaded down or tinted down easily as much as the right ones, because I am, of course, right-handed. It's a bit difficult to get it just as precise on the left side as I do on the right side. So that's why I usually stay clear of making slopes on the left, or like the right side of mountains, or on this, yeah, on the right side of mountains, because on here I'll be doing on the left. But in this case, I am going to have to do both. I've done it before, it's just not comfortable. Make these shorelines a bit diverse here. There you go. Seems pretty all right. I don't think I'll do waves this time. I'm not really good at waves. And I'd rather not experiment on this piece of all pieces. I'll try some shading to give the shore some detail, but that'll probably just be it. Won't be able to do anything past that. won't be in my ability to make it look presentable. It would still happen, it just won't look good. Edit this mountain a little bit. I'll make it look alright. This feels much right here. It's wider than normal. It's not supposed to be. Not off to a good start. That piece is, needs to be scrapped because the old paint is coming off. That ain't good. just like that. There we go. This is shading to the shore. So, sorry if I'm a bit quiet this session. Just this type of mountain is a bit difficult. So I do have to have some concentration put into it. Where I could kind of turn my brain off with normal mountains, I can't with this. They're special mountains. I'm gonna stand up to see if the recording is still recording. And it is. We're all good. Okay. All good. Just gotta check because my phone's turned around at the moment to record a bit better. Now for the other side. Let's hope it's not as bad as I think it will be. I smell like bananas. Like the banana Laffy Taffy. Everyone said that they're gross, but I always liked them. The yellow paint, coincidentally, kind of smells like that, strangely enough. I mean, this type of paint kind of smells like the food they're kind of associated with, I guess, I'd say. Which is strange, I didn't know they would do that. I doubt they get the pigment from the fruit, but just associate the smell with the fruit, and it smells very similar. Like, the light green would smell a lot like green apple. And the red would, the bright red would smell a lot like cherries. Very strange. I don't think they put scents in them. I have to check the label. But as I checked, they didn't. I mean, a lot of this is painter's touch. A Rust-Oleum I'm using. I don't know if they added something to the painter's touch variant. They might have, I don't know. Don't really keep up to date with what's going on in the Rust-Oleum labs. It's not as bad. I don't know how much paint just got off there, but that was a lot. Too much. Gotta even that out. There we go. Okay. It's good. This is a little bit easier. Maybe because I already trained a little bit on the other mountains. Being picked up, and I don't like it. Don't want grays in these mountains. Want bright colors, yellows and whites. No grays. I need contrast, not that heavy blending. Paint. I guess this is the yellow I wanted. Too much yellow. Which I gotta be careful what I wish for. Okay. I'm wiping out my pants to not just have a lot of stuff on here. I can do it on my pants because these are just my paint pants. I don't use any other pants. And I only use these pants for painting. I love my shirt, socks, hats, everything else. It is a pain to clean. Paint out a nightmare. It's awful. Unless you have like the perfect thing for it, you're gonna be stuck with it for a really, really, really long time. just white just got picked up and how it did. And it is not going away. Can I even paint down how thin it is? What does it want to move down? Yellow one there. Okay. I want to get this back. Spire. All settled. But it's going to stop at that line. It's not going to go any further. Ain't going to cross it. What did crossover? There we go. Yeah, turned out pretty alright. Yeah. Not gonna have a lot of snow. I'm not gonna have a lot of snow on there. Doesn't really need it. I am going to add some fog though, just to have a little bit more yellow, just an excuse really. So it will be pretty fun. Yeah, I like it. Opposed from, of course, these. I think it turned out really well. Except for the shading, which really bugs me. Turned out pretty alright. I'm actually gonna see if I have a hollow piece, hollow stencil that I can use. Because I might just have it. Almost perfect size. Right. Where
lights over here.
Okay, there should only be like three that should be needed. The rest are fine. What do you need? Yeah, I don't really need to weight this down a lot. But I do have to be very careful here, as if I mess up, I am screwed. Royally screwed. And I do not want that. I just have to have that shading. Hopefully that seam isn't there when I remove it, because there was a small little seam inside there. Oh, yeah, I botched it. Man. Gosh darn it. Okay.
There's gonna be another one.
This one, really hoping that it works. It's a bit bigger, or at least the same size. Okay. Alright. I'm gonna use this now. Really hoping this ain't gonna bite me in the butt later on. But no, who knows. I just had to try. Okay. Right. First, I gotta get the shade over here. Then some lighting, if I could find it. Come on now. Let's get some lighting. Just to gloss over the mistake, awful mistake I made. I think it's gonna look pretty well. Yeah, it's fine. Okay, now for this one. Uh-oh, it's okay. I don't really need a lot, just enough. Gonna put this over here. Oh no. Okay, yeah, that works. Is this? Alright, let's take it off. Praying that it looks alright. At least it didn't stick to that. It's not sticking. That's at least a good sign of one thing. But I got a bad feeling that this ain't gonna look good. Eh. It's alright. It botched the other stuff, but it's fine. I'll deal with it, I guess. I'm gonna put this up and then go gloss it, sign it. Not my proudest theme painting, or my proudest painting in general, just because there's two canets. Everything else is fine. I mean, this paint's good in the middle. And the comments over there are good. And alright. Egg is okay.
do that a bit more definite.
There we go. All right, well, I hope you did enjoy this little, I mean, it wasn't a disaster, but it wasn't perfect either. I mean, it's much better than the other one, though, I'll tell you that. I was able to actually put it off. It's not gonna look terrible, and that's fine. Now I can hang it on my wall, and it'll fit in perfectly. Well, not perfectly. It would just be the bad one of the bunch. But it's fine, it's presentable. And let me get this so you can pick it up for later on, take a picture of it, what have you, post it. Yeah, thank y'all for watching and enduring with me this little trouble of mine. And I do appreciate you stopping by and watching my one of my painting sessions of one of my theme paintings. And I hope you have a good rest of your day, whenever that may be. And I do hope I may see you again, hear from you again, if you decide to comment down. Any suggestions, any criticisms of my art, it'll be welcome. I'm fine with that. And until next time, I'm going to walk over here so I can turn it off. Until next time, bye-bye.